He led all of NCAA Division I in assists last year. He's one of the leading goal scorers in the nation this year, and he's a finalist for the 2010 Lowe Senior Class Award. Who is he? He's Loyola University Maryland senior forward Phil Bannister, and he sat down with Greyhounds All Access to talk about his growth on the field, in the classroom, and in the community. The class in Lowe's Senior Class Award stands for celebrating loyalty and achievement for staying in school. Though Bannister has always had professional soccer aspirations, academics took priority in the balancing act between school and soccer.
I feel like it's important to balance both academics and obviously the soccer, because like, you're a student athlete at the end of the day, and when, especially when you first come in as a freshman, you can be overwhelmed a bit. Like, you're at practice for three hours a day, and then you've got to go to class and you've got to do your work. It's just all about balancing your life. You've got to balance your lifestyle well and make sure you're living the right life from 6 till 6, like 6 p.m. till 6 a.m.
Bannister serves as a captain on this year's squad, and both he and head coach Mark Metrick say one of Bannister's biggest challenges was learning how to lead.
Phil leads by example. You know, I think he's a quiet lad and he's a pretty unassuming young man, and which is a pleasant young fella, but and he's not in your face about being competitive, but I think deep down he's very competitive, and I think he's led by what he's done, not by what he's saying he's going to do. So I think people naturally will look at him because obviously on the field he's talented and been a major player for us, and so he's looked up to in that way. But then off the field he's getting a 3.5 in marketing and public relations, and he's looked up to in that way. So I think his leadership style has been about what he does.
People are fulfilling different roles, people are having to step up now, and I feel like that was my biggest adjustment this year. And I'm not the most vocal type, and we don't really have a vocal leader, like tenant from the past, so I feel like just putting an arm around players and making sure that they're learning and we're keeping them in the right shape.
Through Loyola's first 10 games this season, Bannister leads the nation in goals per game and ranks in the top 5 of points per game, total points, and total goals, all while adjusting to the intricacies of American college soccer.
It's definitely different. I feel like when I've come over from England, obviously I was playing with boys my age, and then I've came over and it's a small player, like not exactly a big stocky player, so it's a lot more athletic college level, and I think that's a massive adjustment when you first come in. As a freshman, you need to get that side of your game. You need to be able to cope athletically as well as technically, because you're playing against big, strong boys, or like the men actually, 22, 23-year-olds, and you're an 18-year-old. I feel like that was the biggest adjustment.
I think Phil Bannister's obviously done exceptionally well here. You know, he's an excellent player and a gifted player on the field, and obviously a very good forward and scored a lot of goals, and has been an integral part of our success over the 4 years. But also, and what impresses me, off the field, he's been a quality young man. He's done exceptionally well academically, and I think that's hard to do, to be so devoted and dedicated to the athletic side of things, and then still have the presence of mind to focus on his academics and do really well there.
For all of Bannister's work on the field, the senior has also made important contributions away from campus, helping out local food shelter Beans and Bread, and also helping dig out residents from a snowstorm last year.
I mean, it's important to give back at the end of the day. I've had a great opportunity at Loyola, and I'm really grateful for what they've given us. So I feel like you just have to help out people who are less fortunate, because you can really impact their lives, and even just doing little things.
Phil will graduate from Loyola in December as one of the most decorated players in Loyola men's soccer history. But he will be missed for much more than his impact on the record books.
Phil's been an excellent player and an excellent student athlete for us here at Loyola and in our men's soccer program. So obviously, it's the end of that chapter, at the end of this season, and we'll be sorry to see him go. But on the other hand, I'm pleased with the way he's grown here, both on and off the field, and I think he's in a very good place, and I'm really looking forward to seeing what he does next. And I know his ambitions to play professional soccer, and I'm excited to see how that goes, and looking forward to that next chapter for Phil.
You can't always rely on, I'm not going to play soccer all my life. I needed to make sure I had something to fall back on, and I feel like Loyola was a perfect place to come.